Happy Life, Chapter 96. Whenever possible, be mindful of your personal appearance. Neither overdress like a model, nor undress like a slob. Clothes are made for the person and not the other way around. Fashion is a money-making market, invention that exploits people's foolishness and immaturity. A clean outfit that protects the body, even if it's outdated, is worth more than the latest, oftentimes ridiculous creation. Do not feel bad for not being in vogue, which is always short-lived. So here Joanna is inviting us to pay attention to some of the values that are instilled on us as being essential, important, such as fashion, being, you know, wearing the latest things that are placed out there. And here she speaks about clothes, but there's so much that our culture, very materialistic culture, instill in us in subtle and not subtle ways, and that becomes the norm for a culture that is very materialistic and whose values are distorted. And a lot of times, the pursuit of these values end up bringing tremendous amount of suffering and distress to our lives. And people who are not able to meet these standards find themselves to be unworthy and of less value than others, which is, again, is a big illusion and also a big lie. We are not worthy by anything. Our sense of worth can never ever be defined by anything that is material. Everything that is material is, in some ways, relatively speaking, an illusion, and does not define the spirit, who is immortal and is defined on its birth as being an heir of God and therefore worth it without having to do anything, just because it simply is a child of God. But Joanna also reminds us the importance of self-care and self-love. And yes, we are in a material world, and it is important that we care for our physical body, for our physical appearance. That should always be a reflection of our inner world and how we deal with ourselves inwards. So present yourself in a clean way, simple way, dress appropriately. You know, a lot of times when we don't do those things, it does become a reflection of how we are treating ourselves internally, with self-neglect and the lack of self-love. So being careful to yourself, to your appearance, to your physical body, it is a sign that you care, that you love, and that you are taking care of yourself. So again, it all comes down to a balance and finding, you know, what works for you. But the most important thing is, she highlights to us in this lesson, is don't feel bad for not being vogue. All those things are short-lived. They are not real values. These are things that our society, our culture creates, and we buy into it. And a lot of times, those trends become extremely destructive. They are very destructive, and we see the negative effects, particularly in our youth, that is very, very vulnerable to what the media and society is putting out there. But in order to have a positive effect on the youth and society as a whole, it's important that we start with ourselves, each one of us, taking good care of us and trying to do what is reasonable and what is in line with our understanding and certainty about who we are in essence and the immortality of our souls. Have a great day.